welcome to math class. Let us start this session by an inspirational quote shared by human computer Shakuntala Devi on mathematics. Without mathematics, there is nothing you can do. Everything around you is mathematics. Everything around you is numbers. Children, today I am going to narrate a story from my storybook, and the story title is Ananya's Grandparents. Let us start the story. Children, look at here. She is Ananya and her mother Shraddha. Shraddha is a homemaker. Ananya is very pretty and intelligent girl. Let me introduce Ananya's father. He is Mahesh, Ananya's father. He is an engineer. Ananya loves her father very much. Every day, Ananya used to ask many queries, many doubts in general to her father. And her father, with much patience, used to answer all her queries. Mr. and Mrs. Madhav, Ananya's grandparents, they live in village. Let us continue the story. One day, Ananya's family planned to go to village to see Ananya's grandparents, as Ananya loves her grandparents very much. First, they traveled 565 kilometers by train and 200 kilometers by bus, and they reached the village. Let us find the total distance traveled by Ananya's family to reach the village. Children, as we discussed in the story, Ananya's family traveled 565 kilometers by train and 200 kilometers by bus. Now we are going to find the total distance traveled by them. So whatever I have said just now through the story, so here I have written everything on the board in words. Okay, so everything I have written as words. Ananya's family traveled 565 kilometers by train, 200 kilometers by bus. Find the total distance traveled by them. This is called a word problem. Okay children, what is a word problem? Word problem is nothing but connecting mathematics with our daily life situations. So math is everywhere children. In the previous classes also you learnt how to calculate addition, subtraction. The difference between those sums and this one is nothing but. So we are connecting mathematics with our daily life situations as a story involving mathematical operations. To solve the word problem, you should read the story given word very clearly. Okay, and finally you have to analyze which operation we have to perform in order to get the solution. Let us start the solution. And one more thing I want to clear children. Here for this word problems, copying the numbers in column method and whether which operation we have to perform is not enough. We have to write the statement. Statement means nothing but we are giving the clear information what we are doing in words. Okay, let me read the question and let us discuss which operation we have to perform. So Ananya's family traveled 565 kilometers by train, 200 kilometers by bus. Find the total distance traveled by them. Here I'll underline the word total. Underline the word total. What's the meaning of total? In earlier classes you already have learnt, you heard this word total. So yes, exactly, in addition, the result of addition is called sum or total. So I think you hope you got the process, which operation we have to perform here to get the total distance. Exactly, we have to add the distance traveled by train and the distance traveled by bus. Both we have to add. Okay, so let us start the solution. So here solution, and while writing statement also we should be very clear which statements we can use. So here kilometer I am mentioning, so long distances are mentioned in kilometer. Yes or no children? So we can use the word distance traveled. So here I am writing distance traveled
And instead of writing for every time distance traveled by bus, distance traveled by train, I am giving this as a common statement. Distance traveled. Then now I am writing by train. Yes, 565 kilometers. 565 kilometers. Next statement, by bus, how much distance they traveled? By bus, 200 kilometers. Okay, children. Now, which operation we have to use, children? Which operation we have to perform? Yes, we have to add. So, we have to keep the addition symbol plus. Let us add. Start from ones place. 5 plus 0, 5. 6 plus 0, 6. 5 plus 2, 7. 765 kilometers they traveled totally. So the distance traveled by Ananya's family is 765 kilometers. So here we have to give one statement. So here distance traveled in total. So children, after completing the solution for this story problem, for word problem, we have to write the conclusion. Conclusion is nothing but the final statement. So, according to the given question, what they were asked to find out. So, find the total distance they asked. So, conclusion can be written like this. Conclusion, C-O-N-C-L-U-S-I-O-N. Conclusion, the total distance, the total distance traveled by them is how much, children? 765 kilometer. So for the conclusion we have to keep a box. Okay, children. So it is very clear, even you to learn to put a box over the statement. Okay, children. So in this way we have to solve the story problems. Let us do one story problem from our practice time 2B. Size 2B, heading solve using addition and subtraction. So we have to read the story, we have to read the word problem, and we have to analyze which operation we have to perform, addition or subtraction. Let us read the question. The Sunshine Club newspaper printed 33,530 copies in a year. The Sunshine Club newspaper printed 33,530 copies in 1 year. Of these means total 33,530 papers, copies, 28,395 copies were distributed. How many were not distributed? Now we have to find the number of copies which were not distributed. Which operation we have to perform? So, as I read the question very clearly, let me tell you here how many copies were printed actually? 33,530. From 33,530, how many papers were distributed? So here 28,395 papers were distributed. Okay, so they were distributed. Now we have to find the remaining papers. The remaining papers, the leftover copies were nothing but not distributed. So if you take away from the total number of copies, the total number of copies printed, that is 33,530, if you take away number of copies distributed, that is 28,395, the difference whatever you will have, that is nothing but the number of copies that are not distributed. So what we have to do? By this time you understood, we have to take away. So that is nothing but we have to subtract. We have to subtract 28,395 from 33,530. Okay, children. The distributed copies were taken away from the total copies printed. So, that is 33,530. Shall I start, children? So, solution here. Before writing statement. So, newspaper copies means nothing but children. We can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. Yes or no, children? So, for such word problems, you can use the statement like this. Number of copies printed, number of copies distributed. And the last one, number of copies not distributed. So, here, start the solution, children. So, number of copies. I am writing this statement common for the remaining statements. Number of copies printed. Number of copies printed. So, 33,530. Next statement. Number of copies distributed. Number of copies distributed. How many copies distributed, children? 28,395. Okay. Next. Now what we have to, children? We have to subtract. Yes or no, children? So here I am keeping subtraction symbol. Let us start. 0 minus 5, is it possible, children? No. We can't take away 5 from 0. So, borrow. So, here I am taking borrow. Here it will become 10. And here 3 will become 2. From 10's place, I am taking borrow. 10 minus 5, 5. So, again now I am subtracting 10's place, 2 minus 9. Again, it is not possible. So, I am taking from hundreds. So, this will become 4. Here 2 will become what, children? 2 will become 12. Yes or no? So, 12 minus 9. 12 minus 9, 3. Now, 4 minus 3 possible, or children, directly? 4 minus 3, 1. Now, thousands place, 3 minus 8. Is it possible? No. I'll take borrow. So, here 3 will become 2. Here, 3 will become 13 after taking the borrow. So, 13 minus 8, 5. So, last place, 2 minus 2, 0. So, the difference is, here 0 is in the last place. So, no need of reading 0. So, where we should keep comma, children? After 3 places. So, 5,135 copies were not distributed. So, number of copies, here we should write, not distributed. Not distributed. So, finally what we have to write, children? Final statement, conclusion. Okay, conclusion spelling, C-O-N-C-L-U-S-I-O-N, conclusion. So, how can we write conclusion? 5,135 copies were not distributed. Very simply we can write 5,135 copies were not distributed. Okay, children. So, after that, just put a box over the conclusion, children. Okay. Understand, children? So, from total number of copies printed, we have to take away number of copies distributed. So, we have to take away to find the number of copies not distributed. So, we have to find the difference. I hope you understand, children. Let us do one more word problem. Look at the question, children. Mr. Shenoy had 3,25,765 rupees. Had means 3,25,765 is his own money. He borrowed. Borrowed means he has taken from somebody 1,12,700 rupees to buy a new car. How much did that car cost? Now we have to find the cost of the car. Okay, little we have to think. This line will help us to buy a new car. So to buy a new car, he borrowed 1,12,700 rupees from somebody. Because the amount what he is having, 3,25,765, is not enough. So that he borrowed money from somebody else. Understand, the amount what he is having and the amount he borrowed, he put together and he bought a new car. Means what we have to do to get the cost of new car? So we have to add both the amounts. The both the amounts together sum is nothing but the cost of the new car. Start the solution, children. First statement, amount he had. How much amount he had, children? 3,25,765. Next statement, amount he borrowed. How much amount he borrowed, children? He borrowed 1,12,700. 1,12,700. Now which operation we have to do, children? What we have to do? Exactly, we have to add plus symbol. Start addition, children. 5 plus 0, 5. 6 plus 0, 6. 7 plus 7, 14. Regrouping. Yes or no, children? Okay. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. Okay. Separate the number using commas. 1's period after comma. 1000's period after comma. So 4,38,465 is the cost of new car. So how much did that car cost? This is car cost. Okay. 4,38,465 rupees is the cost of new car. Here, as I'm not having place, so I didn't keep here rupee symbol, you can keep. So here finally 4,38,465 rupees is the cost of new car. Let me write the conclusion. Conclusion, the cost of the cost of the car is 4,38,465 rupees. Okay. The box. So in this way we have to solve the word problems. So the cost of the car is 4,38,465 rupees.
One day, Ananya sat beside her grandfather and started asking her queries, this time to her grandfather. Her grandfather also started answering all her queries with much patience. Let us see the queries asked by Ananya and answers given by her grandfather.
Children, as we discussed in the story, Ananya started asking her queries to her grandfather. Even grandfather also, as we discussed, he started answering all those queries. So Ananya started asking questions. Her first query is, Grandpa, how old are you? Grandpa, how old are you? Grandfather said immediate answer, dear, I am 65 years old. I am 65 years old. Then she asked her second question, Grandpa, what is your car number? So for a while he was little confused. Then he said the vehicle number like this, HR 26 DK 8337. He didn't expect such questions from her. Okay. So after that, she asked her third question, third query. So query means nothing but children, a doubt expressing as a question. In your class also, you will ask queries to your teachers or not? Exactly. And the third question is like this. Grandpa, every day at what time do you have your breakfast? So grandpa immediately started thinking. Okay, then after a while he gave the answer like this. My dear, around 8 a.m. around 8 a.m. So immediately she started asking her fourth question. Grandpa, I am observing every day frequently he'll go to temple. Okay, now tell me, in 1 year how many times do you go to temple? For this, grandfather was little confused. How can he say how many times he visited temple in 1 year? Okay, so after thinking for few minutes, he said the answer like this. Nearly 150 times. Nearly 150 times. So immediately she asked her fifth question. Grandpa, how many people live in this village? So grandpa immediately said, approximately 10,000 people. So she stopped asking her queries. Now let us discuss about the answers given by grandfather. For the first two questions, I am 65 years old. My car number is. So those he gave exactly, because nobody can change those figures. But what about the remaining three? At what time do you have your breakfast? Means can you people say at what time every day we are going to take breakfast? No, there is no particular time. So around 8 a.m. he said means nothing but exactly he is taking breakfast at 8 a.m. No, maybe 7:50, maybe 8:10. Yes or no, children? Because of that reason, so he gave the answer around 8 a.m. And after that, how many times do you go to temple, miss? Okay, do we count that how many times we are going to temple in 1 year? Nobody will count. Okay, some of the areas we will not have such a counting. Will not note down also. So he said nearly 150 times. And about the people also, how many people live in this village, means our India population, we say approximately 130 crores. In the same way, he said approximately 10,000 people. Okay, children, from this, what did you understand? In our daily life, in some of the areas, we couldn't express exact figures. Just we estimate. So, for the three, four, five questions, grandfather estimated the figures and that estimated figure he rounded. Okay, children. So estimation is part of our daily life experience. Okay, here all the figures are rounded. The words, look at here, about, nearly, roughly, around, approximately, will give the idea of rounding of numbers. Okay, children. Anyhow, we are discussing about rounded figures. Let me clarify one more thing. Rounded figures are not applicable in all the areas. Let us discuss. For example, our ages will not be rounded. If you are 9 years old, we should say, I am 9 years old. We should not round off to the nearest tens, and we cannot say that my age is 10 years. Okay, and our flat number, for example, house number, flat number. If my flat number is 336, 336, can I round off 336 to the nearest tens? Can I say my flat number is 340? No. What happened? That 340 will become some other's flat number. Our pin code number and phone numbers. These are the some areas we should not round off the figures. There are 8 planets in the solar system. Can we round off 8 to the nearest tens? And can we say that there are 10 planets in the solar system? No, that is wrong. Now, at present, we are having 28 states in our country. Can we round off 28 to the nearest tens? Can we say there are 30 states in India? No, we should not change the fundamental. Yes or no, children? So some of the areas where we couldn't express the exact figure, there we had to round off the number either to the nearest to 10, 100 or 1000. For example, if your parent planned a party for your birthday, yes, they will estimate the number of people going to attend the function. So depending upon the number of invitations they have given, according to that estimation, they will plan everything for the party. So these are the some areas we should use the rounded figures, and some of the areas we should not use the rounded figures. But rounded figures are not exact figures, but they are very close to the exact figures.
Children, one day Granny and Ananya went for shopping to a nearby city. First, they went to fruits and vegetable market. There, they purchased so many fruits and vegetables. Granny spent 895 rupees. After that, they went to a cloth store to buy frocks for Ananya. So, Granny spent 3,419 rupees for buying frocks for Ananya. Now, let us see how Granny conveyed the total amount spent by her to the grandfather. In which manner she conveyed the total amount spent by her.
Children, as we discussed in the story, Ananya and her granny went for shopping to a nearby city. There, first they purchased some fruits and vegetables. Their granny spent 895 rupees. After that, they both went to a cloth store. Their granny purchased some frocks for Ananya. Their granny spent 3,419 rupees. So, they completed their shopping. They came back. Now, Granny was about to say the amount spent by her to the Ananya's grandfather. But here, Granny was little confused. Why? Because if you observe both the amount spent by Granny, 895 rupees, 3,419 rupees, they were not rounded numbers. So, Granny got an idea. Granny got an idea. She just wanted to round both the numbers to the nearest hundreds. She wanted to round both the numbers to the nearest hundreds. Then she want to add both the amounts. That sum, the total amount, she wants to convey to the grandfather. So, Ananya's grandfather. So that he can understand easily the amount spent by Granny. Let us see how Granny rounded each amount and what is the sum. So, let us see the solution, children. How Granny rounded each amount. 895 rupees. Okay. So, now we have to round. Granny rounded 895 to the nearest 100. So, when you are rounding off to the nearest 100, right side place, I am 100. My right side place is tens. So, tens place number 9 will be compared with the 5. Okay. Why? Because 5 is the midway of figure. Midway figure from 0 to 9. So, here as 9 is greater than 5. So, next highest multiple of 100 we have to take. Here 8 means next highest multiple of 100 is 9. 8 plus 1. So, 900. Rounded next number 3,490 rupees also to the nearest 100. So, here 4, as 4 is 100's place, 10's place we have to observe. Okay. 1 is compared with 5. So, as 1 is less than 5, so we have to round off to the nearest highest multiple of 100. So, as it is 3,400 because right side of 100th place to. So we are rounding off to the nearest 100th. Right side of 100th place, 10th and 1st place will become 0, 3400. Now 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 9 plus 4, 30, 1 plus 3, 4. So separate the number using commas. See the amount, 4300. How comfortable to convey? Yes or no, children? So she conveyed that I spent yesterday in shopping 4300 rupees to the grandfather. Okay, children. Children, now I am going to explain estimated sum and differences by rounding off as directed from exercise 2C. Estimate the following sum and differences by rounding off the numbers. Rounding off the numbers as directed. The first question is 2,34,578 plus 1,19,934 to the nearest 1,000. Estimated sum. Here plus sign is given. No, we have to find the estimated sum by rounding off both the numbers to the nearest 1,000. So rounding off to the tens, hundreds and thousands, you already learnt in the previous classes how to round off a number using number line. So following the number like hills and valleys and also according to the place value. Solution. So before that, I'm writing the question, children. 2,34,578 plus 1,19,934. Okay, now first I'll round off 2,34,578 to the nearest 1,000. So to round off to the nearest 1,000, what we have to do, children? First we'll underline 1,000's place number 4 and we'll compare 100's place number 5 with the 5. Okay, with the 5. Why? Because 5 is the midway of the number from 0 to 9. So both are equal. When both are equal means if the number is equal to 5 or greater than 5. Equal to 5 or greater than 5. So we have to round off to the next highest multiple of 1000. If it is less than 5, we have to round off to the nearest highest multiple of 1000. So here it is, 5 is equal to 5. So to the next highest multiple means 4 after which thousands will come, children? 5. So 2,35,000 and hundreds, tens and ones will become zeros. Okay, to which place we are rounding off? Which place we are rounding off? That is thousands place. The places to the right side of thousands will become hundreds, tens and ones will become zeros. Let us take the next number. Okay, children. So I will rub this. So 1,19,934. So this number also I am rounding off to the nearest 1,000. So here 1,000 place number is 9. Okay, now 9 is in 100th place. So 9 will be observed with the 5. So 9 is greater than 5. So we have to round off to the next highest multiple of 1,000. So here 9, next highest multiple means nothing but, children, if you add 1 here, 9 plus 1 will become 10. So automatically this, okay, 10,000 place will also change. So here 19,000, 9 plus 1, 10. So again carry over to 10,000 place. So totally what it will become? 1,20,000. Okay, children, when you are adding 9, okay, when you are rounding off to particular number, if particular place 9 is there, you have to take the next highest multiple. Automatically, it left side place also will change. So here we are adding 1 in thousands place. 9 plus 1, 10. That 1 carry over to 10,000's place. So here 90,000 will become 20,000. Come on, now we have to add. After that, finally, we have to add. Okay, children. So, 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 0, 0. 5 plus 0, 5. 3 plus 2, 5. 2 plus 1, 3. So, here, 3,55,000 is the estimated sum of 2,34,578 and 1,19,934 by rounding off to the nearest thousand. Okay, children. Look at the question, children. 5,674 minus 876. We have to estimate the difference by rounding off to the nearest 10. Let us start the solution, children. 5,674 minus 876. Now, I'll round off both the numbers to the nearest 10s. So, which place we have to observe, children, here? 1's place. 4 is observed with 5. So, we are rounding off the nearest 10s. 4 is compared with 5. So, 4 is less than 5. So, there is no change in 10's place. Nearest multiple of 10. So, 5,670. Okay. When the number is comparing is less than 5 means there will be no change. Okay. In the rounding of place. So, next time round off 876 to the nearest 10. Okay. Nearest 10 means 1's place digit is 6. 6 is compared with 5. 6 is greater than 5. Okay, 10's place number is 7. It is rounded to the next highest multiple of 10. That is nothing but 7 plus 1, 8. So, the rounding of number is 880. So, we are rounded to the nearest 10. So, 1's place will become 0. Right side of 10's place, 1's place is there. So, 1's place digit will become 0. Okay. Now, which operation we have to perform, children, here? Subtraction. So, let us subtract, children. 0 minus 0, 0. 7 minus 8, not possible. Take borrow from 100's place, 6 will become 5 and 7 will become 17. 17 minus 8, 9. So, again 5 minus 8, not possible. Again, take borrow. Here from 1000's place we will take borrow. Here 5 will become 4 and here 5 will become 15. 15 minus 8, 7 and 4 as it is. So, okay children, separate the number using commas. 4790 is the estimated difference of 5674 and 876 by rounding off to the nearest 10. So, this is the method, children. Please practice once again.